come through in the clutch, leaving all these haters crushed. Take a look in the mirror on the competition.
All right, so we're back. Los's Notes number 11. Yeah, it's been a minute. We haven't put any of these out for the past couple of weeks. Just so everybody is aware, we've been in that place. We've been where a lot of individuals get to and don't want to basically expose it or share with other people. Clutch Studio, we different. We out here making sure that we can make a difference, but not only that, that we can bring value to any and everybody that we come in contact with. So as we were in that valley, we all, the entire team, plus all my family members around me, continued to come and support us as much as they possibly could. So I'm blessed and honored to introduce a brother of mine, Angelo, with our coffee house.
Hey. Thanks for having me, Lois. Appreciate you being here,
hey,
man.
Hey, brothers. This is what we do, man.
Man, so ultimately, for me, being able to have someone like Angelo here next to me, in front of this camera, a lot of the stuff that happens behind the scenes, one of my support systems has been him. The reason we jumped into the things that we've jumped into have a really, really big impact and a really, really big back end on having Angelo support us, man, and what we're doing. So, like I said again, man, I'm honored and I'm humbled, bro, to be able to just continue to give these people the realness, all of the stuff that we go through, man. So,
hey, man, the water flows under both sides of that bridge, brother. You know, and man, I couldn't thank y'all enough, brother. So, you know, and then look at us now, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
I mean, from when we first started, initiated convo, hey, I can help you here. Now we just. Man, that's my dude.
Hell yeah. So I think ultimately, man, a lot of people here, you know, hey, if you need some help, you know, just give me a call, you know, and it's kind of like a hey, what's going on type of deal.
Man, it's more of a like, don't talk to me now, though. You know what I'm saying? It's a kind of way of saying go to hell, yo. Yeah. Or like, it's small talk, bro. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, you know, there's always conditions, man. You know what I'm saying? It's always like, yeah, hit me up if you ever need anything, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you didn't even say how you did. What's going on with you now? You know what I'm saying? How many times your phone ring, man? For real, how many phone calls you get a day? People checking on you. How you doing, Los?
Not checking on me, man.
Nah,
I guarantee
bro.
You on
they
that.
Think so,
I guarantee.
Right?
Yeah, for sure. But I can't be someone to say that in those times when I've definitely just prayed for someone to just check on me, man. Angelo, you've done that, man. So I appreciate that, man, tremendously, bro.
Hey, brother, you know, that's the thing, though, bro. You know, I say water don't flow uphill, brother. You know what I'm saying? Like, it did keep moving, brother. And water is a humble element, brother. It hustles hard, brother. It pushes downhill, bro, man. You know what I'm saying? It's lonely at the mountaintop.
Oh, brother. Yeah.
And that's the illusion, though.
Yeah, I want to get into that, man. I think that's extremely crucial for people to understand and people to know. Coming from a position of being someone who feels like we just want to continue to help every individual that we can come in contact with, bro. But ultimately, it is lonely at the top. I mean, once you hit that stride and once you get to where you're thinking that you want to be and you hit that level,
man, you know, it is, man. It is lonely, bro, because it don't even feel genuine anymore. You know what I'm saying? You know, even the company, yo, oh, yeah, you know, it looked like the crowd's growing bigger, brother, but hey, you know what I mean? It's just, they got the next same thing, the next, you know what I mean? It's just like, man, how can I pimp this? You know what I'm saying?
Right,
it's
right.
Like, instead of like, dude, I just want to get them some love, tell them to go on. But, you know, they few and far in between. But when you do, you know what I'm saying, run across them, bro, it don't take long, brother, to know that what is what, you know?
I think that's crucial, man. I think the authenticity, the ability to be able to, you know, the takeaway from this conversation would be the ability to be able to understand that when you got a brother, when you got somebody that you know you can depend on, hold on to that, man, but also build that relationship. One thing that Angelo's taught me is, you know, in that time when I was in need and I felt like I was alone, I didn't have nobody else there for me, this man would check up on me on a daily basis. I don't know if he made it a routine. I don't know if he put it in his Google Calendar. I don't know what you did, bro, but that, I mean, it was a constant everyday communication with me. And it wasn't like you would just ask, like, you good? You need anything?
Hey, man, you know, it's like this, bro. This is a parable, bro. It was a verse when I don't remember how many people Jesus fed with the two fish and
that's right.
And like the stadium, though. But, you know, the first thing he said, though, was, give me what you got. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Give me what you got, people. And that's it, yo. I mean, I remember that time. I was going through my own stuff, bro.
That's right.
I was on
that's
the
road. What shook me. Yeah,
was,
that's what.
I was deep, like, man, what is gonna go down? Like, I was at a critical, critical, like, near death, like, you know what I'm saying, in my journey. But here's the deal. Give me what you got, bro. You know what I'm saying? I know my boy, you know what I'm saying, was going through it. Even them that affirmation, brother, them words, like, you know, bro, let's walk, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because, bro, mighty, bro, I'm telling you, two swords are better than one, brother.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying? You shaking them vibrations up and lifting them out. Look, I know my story and my experiences, brother. And bro, that's value, brother. The little drummer boy just came and played, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's all he bought it. That's what he did. Yeah.
I'll tell you what, man. That
alone, you know what I mean? Like I said, even that simple thing that you would do, man. You swing by, you know, right when you get off, you swing by, or that conversation you would have with me just for that 5 to 10 minutes. I mean, that was enough to give me that energy to get back up and do what I need to do. And I got families, you know, we got families to feed, brother. And for me, it was like I got 15 individuals that depend on me, plus their families, man. And so everybody here in the office and all the team understands and knows that you know, respect and pay homage to Angelo, because it's because of him that I was able to continue to strive to move forward on these things, man. None of this stuff is easy, man.
Hey, bro, you saved me. You saved me. You know, I was just, brother, just, it's like wave undertow, wave undertow, wave undertow. I couldn't get no momentum, bro. And you know, some things were, you know, luckily was getting going, but you came in, gave me some love on them shoots and stuff, man. And bro, that really turned my notch up, brother. You know what I'm saying? Awesome. Like, I was able to bring some more people, improve qualities of life for everybody else, man. And you know, I'm still good. I'm still, you know, where I'm at. But man, there's more people in the equation now, brother. Yeah. And we just, you know what I'm saying? We able to just to shave it. It goes further, brother. Yeah. And man, and you know, and that's give and take, brother. You know what I'm saying? And it's only when you really give of your really true self, brother, then you actually really giving something worth your damn, bro. Yeah. If you give them something that you got a surplus at, bro. Man, that ain't, I mean, not to discredit it, because I'm grateful, but that ain't shit, bro.
I agree 100%. I agree 100%. Given when you really ain't got much and still giving, I mean, I think that comes back tenfold. That makes sense for everything.
I ain't never had it, brother. But I, you know what? God, you know, I know how this thing of life works, brother. And then you put something in the ground, you love it, you water it, you give it some light, but you're going to get something.
Boy.
You're going to get something, brother. We survivors, brother.
That's
and you,
right.
And we got to, you know, there's a connect.
Huge.
Don't make me pass
it. Well, it's huge, man.
I think another thing that I really, really remember that you mentioned to me, man, was to make sure that, you know, ultimately the amount of value that I want to put into every other individual that's out there, to make sure that I value myself first and make sure that I take care of myself first, make sure that my insides are fine, make sure that everything that I'm doing is going to be beneficial to me and to my health before I continue to go out there and try to help everybody else, man. So that struck a chord with me, man. I shared that with the crew, and it's just...
Hey, brother, you know, I mean, the tree got a root before it could fruit, bro. And if it don't have its own space, brother, and you know what I'm saying, its own access to the sun, you know, without something being overcrowded, bro, it ain't gonna do shit. Yeah. It's gonna freeze, bro.
Yeah.
It's gonna maybe everything around it might overtake it, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know,
I think you mentioned the airplane thing,
right? To put the oxygen mask on you first before you put it on the babies is what they tell you every single time. It makes so much sense. I mean, it makes so much sense.
You know, if you can't take care of you, brother, then what good are you anybody else, you know?
I think the crew can feel it. You know, one thing that I really, really like, man, is that we both have that similar vibe when it comes to our teams and our crew and the people that we love. You know, you surround ourselves by family, man, and we consider each other, you know, the people that we have around us family, man. And so my team was able to feel it when I was in that valley, man, and that energy that was getting sucked out of me, man. I was sucking it out of my team as well, man. And I think ultimately when I was, you know, had those little conversations with you, or when I was getting through these things, I noticed how important it is for us to continue to have that vibe around me.
And here's what I'm going to tell your team, brother. Hey, this brother got your back, so have his. Believe that. I know. You know, I tell my employees, man, our employee meetings, I said, watch me. I said, I can't always be here, man. I'm trying to put stuff together. I'm out hustling, bustling, looking for the deals, looking for something, man, looking for the next, you know, musician, looking for the next, you know, anything, you know, something that's going to propel us, that's going to give us a fresh energy, that's going to, you know what I'm saying, be infectious, brother, that's going to propel the synergy, yo. Watch me, man. Yeah. Watch me, please.
Yes.
I'm not asking for much, yo, but I'm going to give you everything I got.
That's
you understand?
Right.
So, I mean, yo, you know, so we got to pull weight, brother.
Yes, sir.
We got to pull weight because,
yes,
this ain't easy, man. It ain't easy what you do, brother. It ain't easy what I do. If it was easy, everybody would do it, brother. And there's a reason why most of the, over 50% of stuff just falls on its face, bro.
But
that's to be inspirational to too, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like we always had odds stacked against us, brother.
Yeah.
And that ain't no excuse. That's the truth.
You got to be.
That's a whole different.
I think it takes that. You know, I've been on this whole trip where it's like, I don't want to say dark place, but I want to say that it takes for us to be in that place before we can get to the place that we're at right now. And we're not saying, I hate saying that I'm on top of the world, I'm this and that.
I like to just say that I'm not in the same place that I was before, and I'm growing. Mm. And so it took that pain before I can get to where I'm at, right?
It's the cracking of the seed of the shell of understanding, brother. It's just like, you know what I'm saying? When you crack that seed, it's a rebirth, yeah. Huh? But it root and it didn't go up, bro. You know what I'm saying? You gotta go both ways, brother. You gotta have your feet under you, you know what I'm saying? It ain't just like, this zoom zoom, yo.
You
gotta catch ground, man. And you gotta go through that. You gotta be there, bro. You gotta go through those times, brother. Because if it's already a given, brother, you don't appreciate it.
That's right. Yeah, that's 100%.
You don't appreciate it. It ain't, you know what I'm saying? Just it's supposed to be, or it's expected. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And it just makes you complacent, bro.
Yeah. I think at the same time too, it also gives us that ability to be able to feel blessed. You know, I know for us, for me and for you both, man, I know mama and I know your brother, I know your dad. I mean, for us, it's just like, God dang, man, we come from, you know, from different lives than a lot of other people, but at the same time, just because we came from a different lifestyle doesn't mean that somebody else's pain isn't the same type of pain.
It
don't make us any freaking different, man. So,
and that's the thing. That's the understanding, brother, that gives us that overstanding. You know what I mean? Because we can relate to everybody.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Regardless of where I'm come from or how I talk or my vernacular, yeah, or how we get down, or even how me and you vibe. It's just, everybody got a story, brother. Everybody is on the same damn planet at the same exact time as us. You know what I'm saying? Just the odds of that alone are phenomenal. But just understanding that, man. Just kind of meeting people on common ground.
Whoa.
You know what I'm saying? People just want to overlook you. If you can't be used, you're useless, brother. And that's the mentality, bro.
Yeah. There's no way.
You
said, that's exactly.
If you can't be used, and like, nah, yep, man, there's something beautiful there.
Yeah. For
you know,
sure.
And that's just, letting everybody have a light, man.
Yeah. Because stay rooted.
Yep. Stay rooted as we're growing. Make sure we stay humble. We continue to hustle hard and know that we all the same out here. Of us are a little bit, going a different path, but at the same time, when we all combine together, when you got individuals that you can know, that you can call, or just understand that you've got somebody that's got your back, man, the odds, I mean, we can beat everything. So I know we're going long on this thing. I know we're going to have a part two, brother. I can't wait, man.
Hey,
thank
brother,
you very
hey,
much,
hey,
man.
The more stars in the sky, brother, the brighter your night, yeah.
Boy, man. Mm-hmm. Angelo, our coffee house.
A-squared,
son. Yes, sir, A-squared.
Alter Ego.
Don't forget, check them out. Where can they check out some of the music?
To be continued.
All right. We're going to be ready for it. Make sure you check out. Look, I got some of the exclusive. Got some of the exclusive merchandise already. A-squared, Clutch Studio, you know where to find us. We appreciate every single person, every single individual that takes a look at what it is that we're doing. Once again, I just want to let everybody know the reason we do what we do is to take those individuals that are in that place. We want to pull them out of that place or show them how they can get to the place to where we're at today, man. We're just blessed. We're just happy. Let's keep doing life, brother. Thank you, guys. Los Angelo.
Love.
We out.
Let me show you how to do this, son. I put my heart and my soul in this, is 2-in-1. A lot of people have been faking, know where you can't run. Clutch studs in the building. If we can do it, man, you can do it too. I'm done.